नमः शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमः शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमः शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमः शिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्।
The first and foremost sacred secret I want you to know. Integrity is falling in love with your higher personality. understand? You do have Sadashivatva in you. You are hardwired for it. It's not that your Sadashivatva is gift from somebody. No. Understand? Just like how when you fall asleep, you put an alarm and tell the alarm, hey, wake me up tomorrow morning. Same way, that's exactly the way I sent my gurus. I sent my gurus to the planet Earth ahead of me and said, hey, I'm coming. Wake me up when I assume the human body. My alarm clocks were my gurus. Hey, wake me up. Understand? They just reminded me to fall in love with my higher personality. Sadashiva. I started my public life in a very young age. Immediately after 12, after I realized my enlightenment, I took my first padayatra as per my guru's instruction. That padayatra is my first enriching padayatra. See, I should say, I started organized public life in 2000. But my public life started when I was 12. How I started my public life? One person at a time. I'll walk from village to village, sit, spend some time. And small boy, naturally people will be curious, all alone. They will come and try to talk to me. Then I'll start talking to them and start enriching. Whatever little way I know. It was a raw, crude, ground level way, one person at a time. So I decided, I am going to start my own way, one person at a time. Parivaraja Yatra happens only when you move out of joy. I tell you, I was moving like a banyan leaf in the breeze. When a leaf falls from the tree, in the breeze how it moves. That's the way I moved in my life. That is why my Parivrajaka, even to remember is a joy for me. I tell you, shortest distance between two points is a straight line. So most smartest strategy is hard work with integrity. That's all. That's the most smartest strategy. I decided Let me sit and start doing, start empowering, start enriching. It's actually, that is the way I remember me even now. When I close my eyes, I don't remember me sitting in a golden throne. When I close my eyes, I only remember the boy, village boy with a stick on his shoulder, a kamandalu. Before Hindus could recognize, I have created a very powerful enlightenment ecosystem. Everywhere, spiritual awakening is happening, enlightenment is happening. People are manifesting enlightenment, manifesting powers, everything.
What is happening as an
Kailasa is reviving the enlightenment ecosystem. The Kailasa will be the place where almost million man power manifestors are living and running. At least 10 million temples and monasteries which are spiritual embassies of Paramashiva, and reviving this enlightenment, power manifesting civilization. Kailas is a place where everything related to super consciousness is revived. All the sampradaya, all the spiritual ecosystems. Kailasa is a place where everything related to super consciousness is revived. All the sampradaya, all the spiritual ecosystems created for enlightenment will be revived. And established in such a way, it never gets lost. There forever serving the humanity.
I am as old as sun, as new as sunrise.
Thank you.
various incarnations happened, gave a breakthrough to consciousness and gave opening to the next level. My responsibility is to introduce new consciousness which manifests powers of Sadashiva.
As Mahamandaleshwar of Mahanirvani Akada, the oldest apex body of Hinduism, I welcome every one of you. I have experienced Sadashiva in his completion, and he has empowered me to transmit that experience to all of you. It's my commitment to all of you. I'll make you experience and manifest Sadashivatva, powers and state and space of Sadashiva.
When you manifest powers, naturally the state of Sadashiva and space of Sadashiva starts manifesting in you. More power manifestation, more integrity, more unclutching, more nirvikalpa samadhi, more joy, more restful awareness, more responsibilism, more enriching, more bliss. This tradition has a capacity to retain its authenticity and originality. My purpose is to make this statement to the world: Hinduism is real.
Ideas move from mind to mind. Energy moves from space to space. Cognitions move from body to body. That is why even Sadashiva needs a body. He assumed the body because he needs body to transmit these cognitions to you.
Whatever I am doing is reviving the original science as expressed in Sanatana Hindu Dharma, Vedas and Agamas of the Hindu tradition. Given by Sadashiva, received by Devi, adopted by Vishnu to run this universe is Agama. Agamas insist on us serving beyond our frame.
Whatever experience, anubhuti I had by my Guru's grace, Atma Pramana, I do acid wash with Shastra Pramana, Apta Pramana, the ancient master's experiences. Whatever finally stand, I share it with the world as Sakshi Pramana. I welcome everyone for the grand feast of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Let us go on contributing, contributing, contributing.
नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम 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 नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्य
नित्यानंदम सुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्याधिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं त्वं नमामि नित्यानंदम दि ऑफर our humble obeisance, our humble pranam at the divine lotus feet of supreme pontiff of Hinduism Jagadguru Mahasannidhanam Swamiji Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, and we welcome all the viewers across the world wishing an auspicious suprabhatam, good morning to everyone. For those of you tuning in for the first time to the Kailasa Nityananda TV, welcome to the official TV channel for Sri Kailasa, the one and only greatest Hindu nation in the world. Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam is the reviver of Kailasa, the ancient enlightened civilization and the great greatest cosmic borderless Hindu nation. His divine holiness is an avatar from and is the supreme pontiff of Hinduism. His divine holiness has made science of power manifestation, yoga and temple based universities for humanity. Sovereign order of Kailasa led by his divine holiness and Nityananda order of monks, nuns and Hindu diaspora are working for global peace and to give super conscious breakthrough to humanity. Nityananda Hindu University with extended campuses in 150 countries is collecting, organizing, preserving, time capsuling, decoding, spreading and reviving 20 million source books of Hinduism and the 64 sacred arts and sciences like Ayurveda, music, dance, sculpting, astrology, vastu. His divine holiness is the 293rd Guru Mahasannidhanam of Shyamala Pita Sarvajna Pitam and present emperor of Suryavamsha Surangi Samrajyam. His divine holiness has survived the worst persecution of many assassination attempts on person and character by anti-Hindu elements. To explore the videos, you can visit Kailasa's Nityananda YouTube channel. Today, there are millions that recognize Paramashiva has come down to planet Earth once again in the form of His Divine Holiness Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, whom we fondly refer as Swamiji. He manifested this grand leela of his life, of each and every one of us to be part, to have the superconscious breakthrough. Swamiji has taken this physical form and come down from Kailasa itself Now that Swamiji is here, we can celebrate his happening on this planet Earth and spread the Kaila message of Sri Kailasa. We invite one and all viewers to share this link with all on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and all the other social media platforms as we continue in the satsang introduction and get prepared for Swamiji's satsang. Swamiji beautifully tells us, please understand, the only way, the only practice which can destroy self-doubt pattern is enriching others. You cannot complete with your self-doubt. You need to understand how much ever the completion you try to do, you will suspect. You will have doubt even on the completion process itself. How you will able to clear your incompletions? Ramakrishna Paramahamsa beautifully says, if somebody is possessed by ghost, we can throw sesame seeds on them and drive the ghost away. If the ghost itself entered in the sesame seed, how you can drive the ghost using the sesame seeds? The same way, the incompletion are such, when your incompletions has entered in the completion, you will not be able to complete. So if you have any incompletion, you can do the completion process and complete it. Get rid of this incompletion. But the self-doubt is such, the doubt in the completion process itself. So the incompletion has entered into your completion. Then how that completion is going to remove the incompletion? So I tell you, the one and only way to get rid of this self-doubt is enriching others. This enriching is not marketing. Enriching is not converting, because converting others, the result is external. With the marketing, the result is external for the sake of results outside. You do marketing or converting, but here with enriching, the results are inside. Enriching is the one and only way we can consciously build ourselves during this pralaya time. Over the last 7 months, Swamiji has been continuously guiding us for what to do during this perilous time. Before proceeding with the rest of the satsang today, let us understand what Swamiji has been revealing to us in these recent days satsangs, ongoing pralaya.
I want all over the world more and more ecosystems getting formed. All these people sincerely, not only they will do, they will click and upload it in the internet. I want all places to start this ecosystem, e-ecosystem. This is the best thing you will do. Not only you have to do, you should just click the screenshot and put it in the Facebook. And so you encourage others to join in your ecosystem, in your time zone. You guys can consolidate yourself into time zones, because it doesn't need to be distance based. It's a Zoom. So it's only time based. Brahma Muhurta of your time. Your time zones, Brahma Muhurta. It can evolve as a beautiful, great spiritual support, especially during this pandemic, pralaya. It is, I will say that it's worthy of $1 million. This ecosystem, what it is contributing to you is $1 million worth. I want all major cities, I want Hyderabad to start this spiritual ecosystem. New York, Los Angeles, Houston, Thiruvannamalai, Vidhi, everywhere. Start this e-ecosystem, Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai. Give a wake-up call during the Brahma Muhurtam. Get up, come on Zoom and start yoga. Malaysia, Australia, Seattle, everywhere. All over the world, I think we should run at least 100,000 e-ecosystem. I'm going to give special gifts for the people who run e-ecosystem. I think Mauritius also should start this e-ecosystem. It's too easy. I think San Jose has done the best job. San Jose can teach how to run an e-ecosystem successfully. E-Kailasa. It is literally the real work of Kailasa. Helping people, encouraging, psychologically supporting. I tell you, this e-ecosystems, e-enlightened ecosystems. I should say that E means digital. Second E for enlightenment. Third E for ecosystem. Triple E. First E, digital, for that E. Second E, enlightenment. Third E, ecosystem. Electronic enlightenment ecosystem. Triple E. And anyhow, all my disciples are all the time only. So, this E Kailasas everywhere. Every city which has E Kailasa, which evolves E Kailasa, I'll be spending and sending special gifts for you guys. And every e-Kailashians will receive personally my spiritual support and blessing. I want everyone, every human being should become e-Kailashian. He should be supported spiritually. Do you know, you get a morning wake-up call, especially from a very loving, sympathetic, caring friend who understands, even if you don't wake up, it's okay, what can be done? He will only support you, encourage you. Even if he screams at you, it will be cute. Because for your health is pushing you. So understand, getting a wake-up call from that kind of a person and that kind of a friends, and you start not only doing yoga, share your experiences, share, spend time, chit-chat. Best thing to have in your life is E-Kailas, Electronic Enlightenment Ecosystem. I want next 1 week to be dedicated by all my disciples, devotees, to make a beautiful E-Kailasa all over the world in every time zone and enroll, enrich as many people as possible. E6E. First E, electronic. Second E, enlightenment. Third E, ecosystem. Electronic enlightenment ecosystem. Then enroll, enrich, enreach. 6 E's. Let's reach out, support every person. I tell you, if you are supported by E-Kailasa, you are receiving the service worthy of support, help, have more and more positive, powerful cognition. Actually, each E-Kailasa can have few acharyas, book reading, even Nirvikalpa Samadhi sessions, unclutching sessions, sharing with each other, supporting each other with powerful cognitions. So there are many people who can really help you with powerful cognitions. We can make a beautiful acharyas list and publish for each time zone. I think world maybe has, I don't know much, maybe 30-40 time zones. In all 30-40 time zones, we can make E-Kailasas, and even locally you can start making your own E-Kailas. We can do it in a very nice way, and I'll absolutely support all of you with everything possible. We can make E-Kailasas for each time zone, and then you can make local Kailasas your own also. For example, in one time zone, if there are 10 cities, all 10 cities can make their own Kailasas and then connect it with the time zone. Or you can have one time zone. So it all depends on the place. Let's make as many time zones, as many Kailasas as possible in every time zone. Because, listen, during this pralaya, pandemic, if you are sleeping more than 6 hours, you are in danger of getting destroyed. See, the pralaya enters into you as excessive sleep initially, then you are gone. Do not allow pralaya to enter you and destroy you. Like how the belly fat destroys your life once for all, sleeping more than 6 hours during this pralaya destroys you once for all. It puts you in wrong pattern. I think this is the best practical solution. E-Kailasas. So all E-Kailasas, please send an email, register yourself and get it organized. Get it organized. We'll support you centrally with acharyas. Organize ourselves. 100,000 E-Kailasa. Million E-Kailasians is the first level enriching we should do.
Yes. One of the aspects of Paramashivoham is Upanishad. The Upanishads are the part of Vedanta, or the last part of the Vedas. The oldest scriptures of Hinduism created between 1500 to 1000 BCE. The Upanishads contain revealed truths, that is Shruti in Sanskrit, and Brahman, about God. The ultimate reality and the way enlightenment, the moksha. The term Upanishad comes from Upa, that is nearby, and Ni is at the proper place, and to sit. And it means sitting near a teacher to receive the sacred teachings. For Swamiji, as incarnation of Paramashiva, the great truths of Upanishad were already there within his biomemory from the very beginning. Dr. Jim B. Tucker, in his book, Past Lives, writes, evidence of past life memories may exist in our everyday lives. Child prodigies, for example, may have acquired certain skills and talents in such high degrees in a past life that those skills become deeply embedded in their consciousness. Our attitudes, beliefs, obsessions, and compulsions stem from our past lives. Even love at first sight has been associated with the past life phenomenon. In Swamiji's own life, he exhibited extraordinary knowledge of the Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, and all the scriptures and memory before the age of 10, even without any formal study. Then later on, we found out that when Swamiji's biological mother was carrying him, she listened to the ancient scriptures again and again. By the age of 3, Swamiji started reciting the whole thing because he heard from his mother's womb. Every day of the year, he would spend at least few hours, if not the whole day, with his gurus. Slowly, he began learning the letters of Tamil alphabet and learned to read and then write. His primary education was purely Vedic, without one ounce of corruption from an invasive school structure. Swamiji says, I can literally just repeat the whole book. Fortunately, even the language was taught to me only by my gurus. I did not go to school that regularly to learn something from school. The book titled Atma Puranam, gifted to the avatar by Isakki Swamigal. He was the guru of Mata Vibhudananda Puri, who in turn was the guru of the avatar. This is the first ever Hindu scriptural book of Vedanta possessed by the avatar. Isakki Swamigal and Mata Vibhudananda Puri would sit for long hours with the avatar, exploring the truths of Vedanta through reading of this book. This book contains the three major Upanishadic texts, that is the Isha, Keno, and Kathopanishads. Mata Vibhudananda Puri would read the verses and explain the truths, while Isakki Swamigal would give his commentary. This book preserved in the biological archives of the National Archives of Sri Kailasha. Now, let's watch a video related to this.
Fortunately, the first ever book is Upanishads by Isakki Swamigal. And still we have that copy with us. We have that book. The four major Upanishads, Tamil translation. At that time I can't read. He will read and give explanation. Kuppamma will ask questions and he will give answers. Actually, only through that book I even learnt alphabets. Fortunately, even the language was taught to me only by my gurus. I did not go to school that regularly to learn something from that school. I went to school whenever there is no festivals in the temple, when I am free, which is less than 60 days a year. Please understand, Tiruvannamalai temple as at least 300 days festival in a year. And in that 60 days, sometime it will be summer holidays for the school and weekend. Anyhow, because I learnt the language to study these Upanishads, that book has become so part of me. It's actually a Tamil translation and commentary. I can literally just repeat the whole book. I can just literally repeat the whole book. Sometimes Kuppammal will read the book And Isaki Swamigal will explain. She will ask some real serious questions. And Isaki Swamigal will answer. I will not ask anything, I will not talk anything, I will never ask any question. I'll just sit and listen. Suddenly Kuppamal asked Isaki Swamigal, Swamiji, this fellow is not asking any question, I think he is not understanding anything. Then Isaki Swamigal laughed and said, no, I am observing. Throughout all these days, his eyes have expanded and very attentive, but his eyebrows never hit each other, having a doubt or a question in his head. So through this body language and facial expression, I know he is understanding the whole thing. He is internalizing the whole thing. That's the first time I understood. If your eyes are wide open, you are attentive. And if your eyebrows are hitting at each other, you are a little confused or you have a question, you are not able to cognize that part. What a subtle study of the body language. So if you do like this, it means there is some part you don't understand, you are not cognizing. But if you do like this, you are just imbibing. He said his eyes are wide open, he's awake, alive, available, receiving. But his eyebrows never hit each other, showing any doubt or unable to cognize. And I saw his inner space is completely imbibing it, internalizing it. I bow down to my gurus, Guru and Paramaguru. Who introduced Upanishads to me in this body. Offer my gratitude to them before entering into the Upanishads. Please understand, I may be a born enlightened being or I may be an incarnation, whatever, but in this body, these great masters have introduced Upanishads to me, so I bow down to both of them with my gratitude. Guru and Paramaguru, with their blessings and with Mahadeva's grace, invoking the presence of all the rishis, I am bringing this great Upanishads to all of you.
During the early years of the revival of Sri Kailasha and Swamiji's whole mission, he began teaching Upanishad first as a samyama, as a way of sitting in deep listening with the Guru. Swamiji first experienced this Upanishad samyama from his own Guru, Mataji Vibhudanandapuri. Once Mataji Vibhudanandapuri asked Swamiji to go and buy the Upanishad book from the market. Swamiji went and searched everywhere, but he was not able to get it. Swamiji came back with a very sad feeling and told her, Ma, Upanishad book is not there. I don't know what to do. She said, don't bother. What is meaning of Upanishad? She asked. Swamiji said, Upanishad means sitting with the master. She said, just sit. Swamiji simply sat next to her. Swamiji then explained the story. Funny thing is, after I sat, she just put her hand in my hand and I saw the Upanishad book there. Very powerful, casually materialized. If you have this power of piousness, will disappear. Disappear pious. The simplicity and the power expressing. Swamiji says that is the beauty. If you constantly has and carries the ego that she has power and she wouldn't even send me to buy the book, she will say, Ray, sit. I will materialize and start this class. No, she would have done that. She did not do that. It means she doesn't carry that in her ego. She doesn't use that for her ego fulfillments. Only when it is really needed, then she expresses that kind of powers. A great pious person in her life, again, she experienced this technique. Today, Swamiji teaches the very same method that Vibhudananda Puri had given him. The Upanishad Samyama, a way to imbibe from the Guru even what can't be communicated through words. In the same way that a baby grows in the womb of its mother when she's sleeping, the soul of an initiated disciple grows when he is seated alone within the self. Upanishad means nothing but sitting with the master. No prayer, meditation, or mantra is needed. All one has to do is sit. Although the fear of falling into depression may arise, there is no need to worry. After all, how long can worries haunt the individual when they are directly confronted? The mind is a powerful thing. It will bring up unnecessary excuses like work and not having time to sit with oneself. However, it helps to look closer and see that every person has as such time as they make for themselves. To find time is to sacrifice an hour of watching television or surfing the net, neither of which adds any value to one's time. Let's now watch how Swamiji explains Upanishad in a very special session in a yatra, where hundreds traveled along with him to the Himalayas.
Today's message, Upanishad. whole Himalayas is Upanishad. Just be. It's constantly radiating. In one this one message, just be. Upanishad means sitting with the master. Himalayas is the ultimate master. Catch this thread of just be. See, if something excites you again and again and again, that is the path for your enlightenment. So make sure just being, the Upanishad, excites you again and again and again. That is your sadhana. Upanishad, just sitting. You can't talk too much about silence. You can only live. You can't say too much about Upanishad. You can only be. Maybe you will sit in the hall and spend more time. Let's gather for next session. Today we'll have some sessions and a lot of activities. So take this as today's message. Just be. Upanishad. Be with these Himalayas. Be with this Ganga. Be with the Master. You have Murti, Tirtha, Stala, all the three. Ganga is Tirtha, Stala is Himalayas, Murti is Master. You have all the three. Experience enlightenment. Achieve and radiate the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
When excuses have lost power over the individual, fears will take over. Fear of failure and fear of depression will attack one's resolve in attempt to break it. But the key is to face these fears. The person will be scared that they will sleep or that they will never be able to complete the samyama. If not, they will be afraid of falling into depression. The key to overcoming the constant stream of worry in the mind is to comfort those worries. When human beings accept that they are truly alone, orphans in this world, they can face their worries. A strong resolve to just sit will fight away with all deviances of the mind. Like how Swamiji sat with Mata Vibhudananda Puri at the age, today thousands of disciples have sat with their guru, Swamiji, and imbibed the greatest truths just within that silence. It is now time to prepare ourselves to be in Upanishad with His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. Let us make a conscious decision to be in the space of deep listening with the simple integrity with Swamiji, that we are there, open and available to receive the revelations from Paramashiva. Let us now chant the Mahavakya initiated by Swamiji. Om Nityananda Paramashiva.
नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम् ओम नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम् ओम नित्यानंद परमशिवोऽहम् ओम नित्यानंद शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्।
Connecting with the divine with your eyes closed is meditation. Connecting with the divine with your eyes open is darshan. Come, let us all now move from meditation to darshan. Slowly, very slowly, please open your eyes.
பாவம் கழி நீங்க பெருவாழ்வினே உண்டாட நித்யானந்த ஸ்புரணம் தன்னை நெய்த அப்பனல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா என்னப்பனல்லவா என் தாயும் அல்லவா தன்னை உணர்த்திடும் தியானம் அளித்தவா
நித்யா 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 நந்தனே
परमशिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरुपरंपराम् I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the living and practicing Hindus. Devotees, disciples, Sarvajna Peetha Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Sarvaparityagis, Srimahans, Kailasas, ministers, ambassadors, diplomats, e-diplomats, citizens, consulate generals, supporters, Mantreshwaras, Vidyeshwaras, Ganeshwaras, Lokeshwaras, Astreshwaras, Paramashivoham, Season 11 participants, I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Paramashiva's message directly from Kailasa. Initiation is enlightenment. Initiation manifests the state of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the status of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the space of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the powers of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the being of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the super consciousness of Paramashiva. Initiation manifests the Kailasa of Paramashiva. in everyone. Understand initiation is the seed which can never be killed. You can deny it, delay it, but can never kill it. You can deny it, delay it, but can never kill it. You can take time. You can waste time. You can be stuck. You can go round and round, beating around the bush. And many time in the name of beating around the bush, you beat yourself. You can beat yourself continuously in the name of beating around the bush. You can delay. You can delay, deny, but can never kill it. Initiation is Paramashiva impregnating you. Listen now. Initiation can never be killed. Listen. Listen and understand this intensely. There are some people who come, feel connected, live like a great disciples. Everything goes well. Suddenly they drop out. They even drop Kantamala. Listen carefully. Feeling connected or dropping out can happen only in the level of teachings, doings. Sometimes they feel I am doing something which they like. Sometimes they feel I am doing something which they don't like. Even if I am not doing something which they don't like, they decide to believe the rumors that I am doing something which they don't like. When they feel I am doing something and saying something which they like, they behave, they are feeling connected. When they feel that I am saying something or doing something which they don't like, even if they don't have any evidence or proof, if they decide to believe that I am saying something or doing something which they don't like, they decide to drop out. Understand? Coming and going is only in the level of doing. Only in the level of teaching, following or not following, is only in the level of teaching, doing. But initiation happens in the level of being. That can never be killed. Once you are impregnated by Paramashiva, the initiation which happens from the being of Paramashiva to the being of Paramashiva, the being of Paramashiva which is in you is initiated by the being of Paramashiva which is in me by the manifestation of Paramashiva. The initiation cannot be killed. Listen carefully. Coming and going, following or not following, being disciple or not, all that is only doing level.
all this is only doing level, following or not, and all this. But initiation happens at being level. Maybe by not following me, by denying me, by keeping yourself away from me, you can delay the initiation manifesting. But you cannot kill it. This is the best good news I have for the whole world. The greatest news. Initiation cannot be denied. It cannot be killed. You can delay it, but you can't kill it. If you are actively following, participating, then it flowers, manifests. If you are not actively participating, it is just, it waits. If you are doing some Guru Droha, Sangha Droha, it gets delayed. But it cannot be killed. Understand? Sometime the human mind believes I am saying something, doing something which you really, really like, love. You just vibrate with it. Be in tune with it. Then you decide to follow me. Then for some reason, you start believing. I am saying something or doing something which you don't like. And you may not even have evidence, or you may not even want to look for evidence. You may just decide to believe. He does something which I don't like. He says something which I don't like. So you decide not to follow, you decide to deny me, you have a freedom. In doing level, you have a freedom to delay, to deny, but in being level, the initiation happened, cannot be killed. Cannot be killed. Listen. In Vedas, Agamas, both clearly says, initiation given cannot be taken back even by Guru. Even Guru cannot take it back. When somebody does Guru Droha, Sangha Droha, it can be delayed. He manifesting the power of initiation, he manifesting the result of initiation can be delayed. But not more than that. Killed. That's the beauty of initiation. I tell you, every time I am sitting with you, whether in the name of satsang or question answer or class, any form, I sit with you guys, it is initiation. Whether you see me or I see you, both see each other. Whether it's a question answer or satsang or just sitting and playing, sitting playfully, casually, sipping cup of coffee, I always visualize myself
sitting with Arunachala, just with few disciples who are literally my extension. I am their extension, they are my extension. And sipping cup of coffee or tea. Same way, sitting with Ganga, with few disciples who are literally my Anga Devatas, my part, and sipping cup of tea, sitting with Kaveri, with few disciples who are just my extension, Anga Devatas, cup of coffee. Whether it's a satsang, a sitting with a cup of coffee, it is initiation. It cannot be killed. It cannot be killed. Everything, everything happens between you and me is initiation. It cannot be killed. Listen. Tadadi divyatam tavat shinuyat pavasandadi tena dikshedi vikyada munibi tantraparagaihi. Diksha is the one which bestows divinity and destroys the continuity of restrictive karmic bondage. Hence it is called as Diksha by the munis and the ones who are experts in the Tantra Shastras. This is Gautamiya Tantra, 7th chapter, 2nd sloka. Let me repeat. Tatadi divyatam davat शृणुयात् पापसंततिः तेन दीक्षेति विख्याता मुनिभिः तंत्रबारहै पारकैः मुनिभिः तंत्रपारकैः व्हेन इट जॉइन्स मुनिभिः तंत्रपारकैः इट बिकम्स. Understand? Diksha can't be destroyed. Diksha is Jivan Mukti. Diksha is living enlightenment. Diksha is manifesting Paramashiva. In Kamikagama, Purvavada, 4th chapter, Archana Vidipatalam, 59th sloka, Paramashiva very clearly says, Dikshitoyaha Puman Sakshat Jivan Muktasa Uchyate. The one who has been initiated, received Diksha, is considered to be evidently a living liberated soul, a Jivan Mukta. I don't even want to say considered. Uchyate means declared, defined. Uchyate is not considered. It's the wrong translation. Uchyate means declared, defined. Dikshidoyaha Puman Sakshat Jivan Muktasa Uchyate. The one who has been initiated, received Diksha, is considered to be evidently a living liberated soul, a Jivan Mukta. Pick up your Atma Linga. Today I'll give the initiation. Take the Atma Linga and keep on your heart center. Heart chakra, just below the heart and above the navel, Anandaganda is the region through which initiation happens. So keep the Atmalinga on the heart chakra, center of the heart. Hold with both the hands.
Paramashiva, Paramashiva, Paramashiva.
There is only Paramashiva. You don't even have to think you are Paramashiva or you are surrendering to Paramashiva. Actually, there is nothing other than Paramashiva. Whatever you think as you is Paramashiva, whatever you think as Paramashiva is Paramashiva. Whatever you think itself is Paramashiva, source of your thinking is Paramashiva, the energy with which you are thinking is Paramashiva, the energy with which you are denying Paramashiva is also Paramashiva, the energy with which you try to imagine Paramashiva is Paramashiva, the energy with which you try to visualize Paramashiva is Paramashiva, the energy with which you think whether Paramashiva exists or not is Paramashiva, the energy with which you have self-doubt is Paramashiva, the energy with which you have self-hatred is Paramashiva. The energy with which you have self-denial is Paramashiva. So, there is only Paramashiva exists, nothing else.
Paramashiva, 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 Paramashiva. Paramashiva, 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 Paramashiva. 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 Param.
நித்யுகம் காக்க வந்தான் வரம் தந்து எம்மை வளம் காண செய்தான் உளம் கொண்ட மாறான எண்ணங்கள் நீக்கி
பரமசிவ 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 Paramashiva 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 Paramashiva
நோடு உயிர் தந்து உணர்வோடு மொழி தந்து உலகெங்கும் உயிர்ப்பானவன் புவி தந்து மலை தந்து கடல் தந்து நதி தந்து முகிலாகி மழையானவன் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன் நித்யானந்த வந்து விட்டாள் சுடராக திரு நின்ற திருவண்ணாமலையூரில் நித்யானந்த கோலம் கொண்டாள் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன் கலைவாணி மடி மீதில் இசைகின்ற வீணையான அசையாத மனதுக்குள் அம்பாளின் இசையாக ஆனந்தம் தரும் முனையானாள் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன் நித்யானந்த வயமானவன்
ஞானத்தில் வென்றவன்
Shiva, Paramashiva, Paramashiva. Listen, I bless you all. Now, listen to this announcement very carefully. I am giving the series of satsang on Hindu parliament and Hindu democracy. I am explaining 36 tattvas. Shiva tattva, Shakti tattva, Sadashiva tattva. All the tattvas. So anyone who understands, becomes qualified to be part of the Hindu governance, Hindu parliament, Hindu democracy. See, as I said, Hindu democracy is responsible democracy. People who are educated in that field, introduced to that field, involved in that field, only they vote. So today I am declaring, everyone who is initiated by me, whether you are still a follower or not, you are authorized. You have a right to vote in Hindu democracy of Kailasa. I am giving you the voting right in Hindu democracy of Kailasa. Whether you are still a follower or not, immaterial, because initiation cannot be killed. Understand, soon I am going to start the activities of Hindu democracy and Hindu parliament, Hindu governance of Kailasa for public. See, it is happening from the time literally I am initiated, ordained. At the age of 3, my gurus have made me do Chaturmasya Vrata by making me sit on their lap, and they started doing the Chaturmasya Vrata. Means training into sannyas. I should say that they initiated into sannyas and started training me to manifest my life's mission, like my life's purpose. Then every training they made me go through and initiated me, ordained me. Ultimately, at the age of 16, when I was 16, 1994, I think, they did the Yoga Pattabhishekam. And after that, within few months, all of them left the body one by one, went into Jivan Mukti, that Jiva Samadhi.
only Ramaswar Kumar waited and Tiruchi Swami, both of them waited till me getting settled and established. Once they saw I am established, they also left the body. So in 1994, when I was 16, they put me in Yogapattabhishekam and put me on the throne, on the seat as successor. From that time, the revival of Kailasa is happening through me. Now I am opening that to public. For anyone who is initiated by me, they can participate. The voting activities will start very soon because we are going to be allotting the number, unique number for everyone initiated. You can use that number and cast your vote digitally. It will be completely e-voting system, digital voting system. From wherever you are, you can vote. For various issues related to Hinduism, the policies of Kailasa government will be decided democratically. So the first question, we are going to have voting. Do you want non-vegetarian food to be kept as an option for Hindus, or should not be an option for Hindus? All practicing Hindus, should they be allowed to consume non-vegetarian as a regular food or rare ritualistic food, or completely should be stopped? This is the issue. We are going to take it up first. Soon we will come up with a questionnaire and leave this question open for voting. So every issue Hindu society is facing, every issue Hindus are facing, we will start taking votes. We will start conducting elections on every issue Hindus are facing in the modern day. I'll announce the first election date. This is the principle, concept. The first election will be for this principle about the non-vegetarian food. We will give you the definition of what is vegetarian, non-vegetarian, the various levels of vegetarian and non-vegetarian as per the shastras, and then the options. You can get educated and then vote. So soon we will be conducting the first election for public, where anyone initiated can participate in this election. All initiated ones gets the voting right.
With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness, and Kailasa Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.